A Study in Sherlock and His Creator, 50 Years of the Arthur Conan Doyle Collection, is a free exhibit at the TD Gallery at the Toronto Reference Library. To celebrate the 50th anniversary of the Toronto Public Library's renowned research and reference collection, this exhibit explores the many facets of the world's most famous detective writer and his ever-popular character, Sherlock Holmes. It showcases gems of the collection, such as rare and first editions, one-of-a-kind letters and manuscripts, photographs, film posters, original artwork, and more obscure oddities. Here are a few of my favorites. The exhibit includes several first and early British, American, and Canadian editions of Arthur Conan Doyle's original Sherlock Holmes stories and novels. This includes the exceptionally rare first edition of A Study in Scarlet in Beaton's Christmas Annual. This 1887 edition is the very first time Sherlock Holmes appeared in print. The story describes the meeting of Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson and sees them solving their first crime together. Another highlight is the first edition of The Hound of the Baskervilles from 1902. Artists and illustrators helped shape the iconic image of the great detective. This is an original pen and ink and wash drawing for The Adventure of the Cardboard Box by Sidney Paget. It was published in the Strand magazine in 1893. Paget is largely responsible for the image of Holmes seen today. There is also unique stained glass designed by Toronto glass artist Joseph Agner, 221B Baker Street. One of four pieces commissioned by Dr. Peter Leminski, a collector specializing in Sherlockian artwork. The exhibit includes some of the countless versions of Sherlock Holmes that have graced the stage, radio, film, and television screens over the past 100 years. This theater poster for the play Sherlock Holmes features an illustration of actor William Gillette in the role of Sherlock Holmes. This play first premiered in 1899. Gillette co-wrote it with Conan Doyle and starred in it for over 30 years. It is credited as the source of the phrase, "Elementary, my dear Watson," which never actually appeared in the Sherlock Holmes stories. Fans of the Granada Sherlock Holmes television series may notice a program for a 1988 stage production of The Secret of Sherlock Holmes, signed by actor Jeremy Brett. The library is fortunate to have acquired one of the largest sets of correspondence between Conan Doyle and his editor at the Strand magazine, Herbert Greenhouse Smith. The Strand magazine was an English monthly magazine. Of the 60 Sherlock Holmes stories Conan Doyle wrote, 58 were first published in the Strand. These letters offer a glimpse into Conan Doyle's writing process and the business side of publishing. While best known for his detective fiction, Conan Doyle was also a proud and public proponent of the spiritualist movement. Spiritualism is a belief in the ability to communicate with spirits of the dead. Conan Doyle tried to prove the existence of spirits by capturing them on film, known as spirit photography. He claimed that the ghostly face here was his son Kingsley, who was killed in the Great War. Conan Doyle also participated in seances. Planchettes like this one from around 1912 were used by mediums to receive and transcribe messages from the spirit world. Toronto Public Library's Arthur Conan Doyle collection first opened to the public in 1971. It has grown to become one of the largest Sherlock Holmes collections in the world. Over 25,000 items that are housed on the fifth floor of the Toronto Reference Library in the Marilyn and Charles Bailey Special Collections Center. Whether you are a die-hard Sherlockian or curious about books, we think you'll uncover something of interest in A Study in Sherlock.